Hello and welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. On the last run, I believe we played as Cain. On this run, let's play as Maggie. Why not? I could play as Isaac a little bit, but Isaac is just such a well-rounded character that I'm probably going to play him a lot, even after I have completed all of the other characters. There's still a lot of stuff that we need, a lot of items that we need, so, you know, why not leave Isaac for as long as possible? That way we can use his D6 as frequently as possible, just sort of reroll into those items. There's a little bit of a lag spike there. Hopefully that'll leave and never show up ever again. All right, now, Maggie. A lot of HP, not a lot of speed, but did manage to get out of the way of these spiders. This is not a XL floor, I do believe, so even if we took a little bit of damage, we should be fine. We are not gonna, you know, lose out on a deal with the devil or anything like that, but what we need is some form of spirit heart. Spirit heart, black heart, anything that can allow us to take one or two hits on the next floor and not lose a deal with the devil, that would be perfect. Until then, we're just gonna move on. Hopefully get at least one bomb somewhere, and then we can pick and choose what kind of consumables we want. If we want some money, if we want some keys. These corn flies are a little bit annoying, but when there's only one of them, or two of them in this case, it's not that bad. But when there's a swarm of them, their movements can kind of get you. Like, you can occasionally take some damage against them. Yeah, that fast guy was going to be a little bit of a problem, but luckily we were able to get out of the way of him. And I think this is the white champion, so I can't actually kill him until I kill everything else, but it does look like I'm doing damage to him, so I'm not entirely sure what the deal with that is. Maybe because he had a fly around him, the game didn't count it for some reason. Sort of like a protective measure to make sure that you couldn't get into a situation where you couldn't kill the guy because it was counting his own fly as needing to be killed, you know. This room can be very annoying. I find that this room, I will frequently just get hit by the... Ooh, that is small rock, that's pretty good. I was just gonna leave and pick up the spirit hearts at the end of the floor, but small rock is definitely a take now. Yeah, I sometimes get hit by that explosive spider. He jumps towards you at the beginning of the room. I think that his direction of movement is kind of just RNG at the beginning of it when you're not in range of him. And it was something like Rotten Baby, the fly will just hit him, kill him, and he'll just explode in your face, and there's not a lot you can do about it. But luckily that didn't happen there. And we do finally get a key, so we don't need to... Well, I was gonna say we don't need to use a bomb, but we don't have a bomb, so it's not like we could use a bomb anyways. Now our tears are killing the flies in one hit, which is good. I do want to try to get the flies in there, the flies from Rotten Baby that is, to deal damage to the boss. All right, we got a pill, we got a moon. I'm just gonna use the moon right now, just because why not? Doesn't matter if we do it on this floor or the next floor, I think. The only thing that we could do is maybe go into a curse room and not take damage on the way out. But I do not think that's necessary. Now with one bomb, I could, and with two keys actually, I might go to the shop. We can't blow our way into the shop, so. We're just gonna have to use a key to get in there, but I would like to buy a spirit heart, and I'd like to buy a spirit heart to protect that deal with the devil chance for the next floor. And there we go, that should be it. 1+1 humbling bundle forever actually would have probably been a good pickup. I should have definitely, now that I think about it, bought that first. But oh well. It's not that big of a loss. Hopefully we will have enough consumables to last us for the rest of the game. Mostly you just lose out on money. Money and a little bit of HP thanks to the double heart drops. I think it is still a good pickup to pick up the spirit heart, just so that we do get that extra deal with the devil chance. And these flies doing good work killing these enemies in one hit before they even get close to me. Well, I guess they are close to me because that's the only way in which the flies will actually aggro on something, but you know what I mean. I really like ooh, that's a tinted rock. We need some bombs before we can do that. I really like Rotten Baby. It's such a good item. The flies are very powerful. They are not related to anything that you do. They just come out and focus on a target. It's such good passive damage, and I am going to take the time, go back, blow up the tinted rock. Who knows what we will get out of it. Likely get a bomb and a spirit heart, something like that. I'm hoping for a spirit heart for sure. Golden chest, could be good, could be bad. 5 cents. 5 cents for a bomb and a keys, probably not a very good trade. I definitely would have just not done that had I known that it was going to be a bomb and a key, but you know, you can't know that ahead of time. There's a little bit of a bad dodge there, and then a little bit more of a bad dodge just because I was a little bit slow, and maybe not panicked, but I was a little bit hesitant to stay in the position I was, so I kind of just dodged a little bit willy-nilly and got hit there. It's all right, though. We still have half of a spirit heart, so we do have a protected deal with the devil chance, and that extra spirit heart should all but guarantee it, as long as I don't have just a terrible, terrible chance time on the boss. There's a battery, there's another bomb, and there is Bum Friend. Sure, why not? Bum Friend, I could go either way on. He's not really all that helpful, especially right now. You know, what are we going to get out of him? A few extra consumables at the cost of money, but we're not really rolling in money. I kind of would have liked to get the money myself, but whatever. It's still a good item to have sometimes. All right, Pin should be pretty easy. The flies are going to do a number on Pin. And he's already dead. Pageant Boy, if there's any nickels, I'll take them. A nickel and a dime, I managed to get those. Bum Friend can get everything else, though. And he didn't pay out with, like, 5 or 6 cents. Damn it, Dark Bum, you gotta pay out a little bit more frequently than that. But we do have enough money now to go into the shop here. And Chaos for 15 cents, I think, is absolutely worthwhile picking up. We get some batteries out of it. That's not really very useful for us right now, but Chaos should allow us to get a bunch of randomized items from all of our item pools from now on. We could get Deal with the Devil items from shops. We could get Deal with the Angel items from item rooms, or from opening up a golden chest. Chaos is definitely very interesting. It may or may not end up working well for us. It could kind of ruin ourselves a little bit. You know, we might not get Guppy now that we've picked that up, because we do have Guppy's tail, but now maybe we don't get Guppy's head because it's not in the Deal with the Devil. It's, I don't know, what's a bad item that could be in Deal with the Devil? Butterbean. It could be Butterbean. You know, and that would suck. That's the risk you take with Chaos, but also we could just get anything. We could get all of our Deal with the Angel items or Deal with the Devil items just from shops and item rooms, and that could be very powerful for us. It could be very useful. At the very least, it's going to be a little bit more interesting. I think we're going to have a little bit more of a debate about whether or not we need to go to Deals with the Devil, go to item rooms and shops in particular. Then again, there could be literally any item in the shop. It could be, I don't know if Polyphemus could show up in there, but you know, Proptosis maybe? Continuum, almost positive. Some really interesting good items that could just be in there now. This is really annoying, getting this guy killed. If that was Skype, that was annoying because I muted Skype, but I apologize for that. Just ignore it. And if it pops up again, just ignore it again. All right, Curse of the Lost. Yeah, Curse of the Lost. Don't exactly know where we're going, so we're just gonna have to keep exploring. Haven't gotten hit yet on this floor, which is pretty good. My play so far has not been the best. It has been a little while since I played Isaac. Also have a little bit of a cold that I'm kind of recovering from, so if I sound a little bit weird, that's why. Please don't hold it against me. All right, another pill. Infested just gives us a couple of spiders. That's all right. Fly's doing a good job. If I could pick up, you know, if I could pick up, what is it, BFFs? No, Hive Mind for giant spiders and flies, that's going to make Rotten Baby probably the... I mean, Rotten Baby right now does a lot of damage. I don't know if he does more damage than we do over time, but it would make him do substantially more damage than us, I think. Just because the flies, You know, you get close to an enemy, a boss, on a small room, those flies are going to be hitting very constantly, very consistently. They home. They're going to be doing a lot of damage. I think it's five times your damage, or I think it's maybe four times your damage when you have Hive Mind. That's a lot of damage coming out. Do need to get a bomb and a key. We do have Guppy's Tail. We haven't been getting a lot of golden chests, which I don't know if that's a factor on a high luck or low luck, because it's lucky that we haven't been getting them, because I wouldn't be able to open them anyways. Come on, keys and bombs. Well, we got some bombs. I think there are some tinted rocks elsewhere on this floor, but for now, we're just going to keep pushing forward. Do you want to get into the item room? Do you want to get into the shop? 12 cents. You know, 12 cents. You know, we could buy an item on sale, but we could also just buy a spirit heart if our HP runs a little bit low. HP is a bit of a concern. We haven't been, you know, rolling in it. And I do still want to ideally go to Hush and Mega Satan on this run, so I need to be able to sacrifice myself at the sacrifice room. There's a sacrifice room on this floor. At least I believe there was. It wasn't the last floor, I don't think. So I need to get some HP on the ground. I need to get some spirit hearts so I can leave this floor with something. That doesn't make my decision any easier about what to do here. I think for now I'm just going to leave the blood bank and we will fight the boss, see what we get after it. The frail, annoying, but I think that we'll be fine with the flies from Rotten Baby as long as they aggro onto him. He's already dead with his first phase. Second phase, I'd like it if he could, yeah, do one of these attacks as soon as possible. That way he stops moving and he stops shooting out those shots that split a whole bunch. Yeah, this is a good attack. Should be able to get around him. There we go. It's a little bit close. Blue map doesn't do anything for us on this floor, but it will do something on the next floor. Now, we can go to the shop or the item room with only one key. We can also fight in the gauntlet room, which we might as well do, maybe get another key out of that, and then we can go to the shop as well as the item room. But for now, we'll just go to the item room, see what we can get. You know what, Attack Fly is pretty good. Kind of does synergize with what we've got going on right now with Rotten Baby. It does mean that we want to get close to enemies. We want to get close. We want to hit them with the Rotten Baby shots. We want to hit them with our shots. We want to hit them with the Attack Fly. Attack Fly does a lot of damage. I should not have taken that pill in case it was something like paralysis, but it's all right. These guys are quite annoying. With low Maggie speed, it's going to be a little bit tricky to get to them, but that's all right. And I think that's it for this floor. I don't think there's anything else for us unless we want to just blow open some mushrooms, see what we get. Infested pill, might as well use it. Get some spiders, and that's it. That's it for this floor. There are some locations for the secret room, but without an active map, it's a little bit of a pain in the ass to try to find. But also, we do have the blue map, so in the future, we can find secret rooms very easily. I'll look for the second secret room. Yeah, I figured it would be here. Not a very good item, so we're just gonna leave. The callus is I was a lot further away from the shop than from the boss room than I realized. I don't want Dark Bum to pick up my money. I kind of want to pick it up myself. Oh, but that's a pretty good payout. An extra heart means that we can play two more times, get some extra money, maybe get a payout in the form of a blood bag, but that's not the case. All right, let's make sure Skype is muted. And it's not even appearing in the volume mixer. I don't know what the deal with Skype is, but whenever I minimize it, it just seems to lose track of whether or not I had muted it before. And then sometimes I can't unmute it. It's a very abnormal process. Thanks to the blue map, we do know where the secret room is, and there is a bomb that dropped. And I do want to blow up these guys. I like blowing up these guys because they have a pretty good chance of giving out a decent amount of money. Some spiders too, but we... We also have a good chance of getting nickels from those money drops. I think you can also get Steam Sale, and I think you can also get Greed to spawn from those guys, but it might just be the shopkeeper that appears in the shops that allow you to spawn Greed. Get the mouse pointer off the screen. I don't think it shows up in the recording, but it shows up on my screen anyways. All right, Dinglet dead. Must be another one over here somewhere. All right, there was a bomb that dropped in that room. I'll go back for it. But I might as well just keep exploring this floor a little bit. We do need to find the item room and the shop. And I imagine I'll be coming back in this direction anyways. This run is a little bit slow going right now, but hopefully it'll pick up soon. I do want to get to Hush. We're already 14 minutes in on the caves part two. That's actually very slow, but we haven't really been getting anything good. We've gotten a couple of damage upgrades. We've gotten Rotten Babies. Rotten Babies, you know, good, don't get me wrong, but yeah, I'll take the Lovers. The Lovers does mean that I might have a better opportunity of getting the deal with the angel sacrifices done, so that's why I'm keeping it. Oh yeah, this is good. A little bit of dumb damage there, but that's okay. Having the attack fly on a Gertie fight is great. It's gonna make short work of this boss. Oh, and we get restock. That is awesome. We can now buy anything we want from the shop and it will restock. This is actually a combination I had at some point in the past when I did the, oh damn it, I hate the rotating brimstone laser. But yeah, this is actually a combination I had in the past that allows us to, let me just check this real quick, all right. Yes, it's a combination that allows us to buy spirit hearts and red hearts from the shop and just use those to do our donations to this, well not donations, but sacrifices to the sacrifice room to get the key pieces. It's a very powerful combination to get the deal with the angels done, to get the key pieces, without having to actually get deals with the angel. You can just get deals with the devil and sacrifice your way to the key piece. So we should not have any problem getting to Mega Satan right now. As long as we find a sacrifice room, we're golden. We can get this to work. Two battery charges is good too. That's two more HP that we can sacrifice. And if it's on this floor, I would love to do it right now. Get it out of the way. Even if it, you know, even if it screws up the spirit hearts that we have right now, you know, that's worth it. We gotta get it done at some point if we're going to do Mega Satan on this run. Now, of course, we might not win against Mega Satan. We do have Chaos, we might get some good items, but we don't have a lot of stuff right now. I do need a lot more than just restock blue map and restock blue map and small rock here. All right, two of diamonds. That's kind of what I was hoping for when I bought the card, the bicycle card. Double our money up to 36 cents. Unfortunately, there are no, oh, that frickin' bomb had such a long charge on it. It chased me down. We don't have the capability right now of buying hearts from the shop. It sucks, but the shop is not, I need to stop dodging into those shots. The shop right now is not all that upgraded on my save file, so I don't really have that good of a get in the shop. I don't have seven items, I only have five. It's gonna happen. I need to do my shop donations, get those done. All right, Pride. I don't think Pride can give us a dead cat. I think that's only Super Pride. We got another Lovers though, and a Power Pill. I guess I'll take the Lovers, maybe we will get lucky. Find a sacrifice room on this floor. And if we do, then we can get some donations done. We've got some battery charges on the floor as well. We've got the Yum Heart. Maybe we can get it to work. At the very least, we can also go to the shop and buy a key so we can get into the item room. Because right now, we cannot get in there. There's also an arcade. So if there is no sacrifice room, we can at least spend some... there is. Excellent. I was going to say we could spend some charges on the... Let's might as well do it once while we're here. Oh, we have the callus. Let's drop that. Pick up the lovers. I do want to leave HP in this room so that I can pick it up when I fight the angel statues. But for now, we will go back, go to the shop, buy a key, come back here, go to the item room, see what's in there, go get the battery charges. Okay. Shop is up here. I think I was in the middle of saying something earlier, but I can't remember what it was. I think it was related to going in here and buying a key. So one thing we could do is we could buy batteries and use those with the Yum Heart. It's a little bit expensive though. It's about 5 cents for a payout, but maybe it could be worthwhile. Mom's Contact, excellent. It is an item room item. You know, that is not the effect of chaos giving us that item, but it's still a good item to get. Got a half heart payout from that. And let's go back, get the other lover's card, which is somewhere on this floor. I guess I could also gamble at the slot machine or the three skull man and see if we can get something out of that power pill. I guess power pill would allow us to play the blood bank a little bit, maybe get some extra money out of that, and then we could, in fact, buy one more battery from the shop, get one more red heart container that we can sacrifice. All right, put the lovers down here. The lovers. We now feel blessed. Just got to be careful that we don't kill ourselves, which is a very definite possibility, in fact. Got to go back now, get some of this HP that's on the ground, be very careful about where we walk. I do not have the callus anymore, so if I walk on a spike, that's it. Very careful. Chariot. I guess Chariot is another way of playing the blood bank for free. Suicide King, Wheel of Fortune, Chariot. Okay, I guess we're just going to go with the Chariot. Buy some batteries from the shop and use those. Oh, excuse me. A little bit of a sneeze there. Note to self, edit that out of this video. All right, let's go buy a couple batteries. This is gonna take a while, but there's really no other way around it. You do need to kind of do this stuff occasionally when you want to get the donations done. Only got a tick from that golden chest. That's a bit of a piss off, but what you gonna do? There's three more HP that we can sacrifice to the sacrifice room. Chariot. Would like to visit the curse room as well, but it's not that high of a priority right now. The highest priority is just playing the sacrifice room. And yep, that's about 5 cents. That's enough for one battery. So anything that gives me invincibility, the chariot card, I think there was another card, power pill, that is just one more play on the sacrifice room here. No reason not to, except for the bombs, no reason to pick up the spirit heart. So I'm just gonna let it sit there in the corner. I am gonna fill up on red hearts though, and this should be the first angel. Yep, there it is. Damage, really low, kind of sucks. But if we get the occasional freezing shot out, I think that'll be good for us. And the flies are going to really be a really big damage dealer for us right now. I did walk into it stupidly, but we should have enough HP to make this work. This is going to be money. Oh no, Bumfriend, no. I need the money. You piece of jerk. I found bills. That's what you paid out with. I found frickin' bills. The next play, I think, is going to be the angel fight. So at this point, we go back, we buy some batteries, we do this again. I don't want to fight the angel statue only on one HP, so I kind of gotta come back here and try this again. There's a spirit heart, so we can leave the floor with... I'll go here once. As long as we don't get hit twice, then this room can be worthwhile for us. There we go. How to jump. Well, we can get out of the rotation. I thought I already saw this item in a shop earlier. Don't walk on the spikes. At least this is not Curse of the Maze, because if it was Curse of the Maze, I would probably have accidentally walked on spikes already. And for 5 cents, we'll buy the card, the Devil. You know what? That's good to have. If we fight Mega Satan, if we fight Hush on this run, we can use the Devil card to really improve our damage for one room. We're not going to fight Hush on this run. As unfortunate as that is, I've got to get this donation stuff done. It's taking forever, but that's just because that's how it is, you know? So at the very least, we can save the Devil card for the Mega Satan fight. And really, the biggest damage dealer we have here is Rotten Baby. Those flies do a lot of work for us right now. That was a bad dodge. But he's frozen. Get in there with the attack fly. There's our second key piece. Now we can, in fact, take the Spirit Heart and we can get the heck out of here. Blow up the skulls. Why not? See what we get. Nothing. Good. Let's go. Now, we do still have Yum Heart, so I could play the Blood Bank a little bit more, but I don't want to do that right now. I just want to go. There's no reason for us to stay. I forgot the Callus. I'm not going to go back for it, though. The correct move is to get the Callus, but we've already been taking our time on this run, so I kind of want to push forward a little bit. Wheel of Fortune or the Devil? Probably the Devil. Wheel of Fortune could give us an item if we take the card down to the chest, but that's a long ways away. A little bit of frozen action there. The flies are able to hit these guys in the back, but they can't hit the zombie skull heads from the front. Attack fly kind of protecting me from these fistula parts. Damage is still very low with our tears, so being able to have these extra familiars protect me is a very good thing. Let's go to these secret rooms, see what we get. We get a key, which is probably pretty good for us. We have Guppy's Tail, so having some extra keys I think is good. We can open some more golden chests, maybe get some good stuff out of those. Any payout from a chest would be welcome at this point, because that is effectively any item in the game, I believe. Well, and as I say that, there's another key right there, so maybe I'd rather have that bomb back. This guy's frozen, but he's not in a very good position for me to hit. There he goes. Bumfriend's still taking my money. I've got restock. I actually have a reason to want to pick up a lot of money on this run. Should also, let's do that right now. Right now, let's spend 2 bombs to pick up 6 bombs, effectively, plus poison bombs. I was going to blow up the key beggar in there. I'm glad I came in here first, though, because that is a great pickup. Now we have 8 bombs. Let's blow up the key beggar and those 2 mushrooms, see what we can get out of this, maybe an item. No, but a couple of cents and a key, that's fine. All right, Maggie, slow as molasses, still need to find the item room, still need to find the shop. Careful of these guys. I hate when 2 hands land at the same time because they push each other around slightly and they can push you, they can push themselves into you. I've never seen that room before personally, but I do believe I have seen images of it. Just a small room in the shape of a key gives us a bunch of keys. Pretty good, can't complain at all. Thanks to having Guppy's Tail, that does hopefully mean we can pick up some more golden chests, get some good items from those. Haven't gotten an item from golden chests yet, I don't think. We have gotten an item from a red chest, though. That was How to Jump, if I remember correctly. Can't hit that guy while his creep is in the way. Can't hit this guy either. All right, that was a little bit of a dumb move. I thought that he would have come out of his stasis earlier, but I guess maybe we had landed more than one freezing shot on him. Yeah, that was a bad dodge. I should have just stayed put in the middle and they wouldn't have been able to hit me. But I haven't fought these guys in a while, so I kind of forgot the strategy for dealing with them. It's alright though, we gotta deal with the devil on the last floor, so not getting one on this floor is not the biggest concern. We can probably get one on the next floor. As long as we can get some HP though, we do need some spirit hearts to make that possible. I don't trust myself right now to not take a lot of damage on the Depths 1. Actually, this is the Depths 1. I guess what I mean to say is take a lot of damage on the Depths 2. I did not see that guy. I did not see that guy. He is incredibly small and really fast. That is very annoying. And I think he did a full heart of damage. So we're going to use Yum Heart. I should have used it before I finished the room, but I forgot I had it until the very end. I hate those small guys because I always end up thinking I have, oh yeah, Book of Revelations is what we're taking here. I always forget that I have it, and I always forget that they're not God's flesh. They're actually just really small. This is Curse of the Maze. Didn't realize that, but we did find Mr. Mega for 5 more bombs. So now we have big poison bombs. That's pretty good. And I would like to get Pandora's Box. So if there's a little bit of money from this, I would like it. There's not, but we can still pick up Book of Revelations. We can get poop bombs, which actually could be pretty good for us, but I think I'd rather just stick with holding on to the money for the next floor. Maybe we'll be able to buy something really good there. Okay, gotta do this room again. A little bit tricky with Maggie's low speed. If we were any slower, then we would have a big problem in that room. The tractor beams might hold us in place so we can never leave. Okay, these little mini mega fatties are dead. Secret room is right there. Quickly take out the fires. Kind of entering and leaving the room so that they stop firing at me, or they don't start firing at me, because there is a little bit of a time before they start actually shooting you. So if you leave, they won't ever shoot you. Gonna push these chests over to the TNT so I don't have to use my bombs. Pick up 4 more bombs. Plus the bomb bag. Okay, we're gonna have a very bomb focused run. Now that I think about it, maybe I should go back and pick up the butt bombs. Because, you know, we could, you know, very easily run into a situation later on where bombs are doing a very large portion of our damage. Yeah, that's the end of this floor. There's a locked golden chest over there, but I'm not going to worry about it. I do have 15 cents to pick up the butt bombs, but let's just leave. Curse of the Blind. That's actually a bit of a piss off. Won't be able to see the items that we buy from the shop or that we pick up from anywhere. And we can pick up anything. We can pick up soy milk from a deal with the devil, I think. As long as the deals with the devil are not kind of locked to not have any special items. I do think that soy milk is a special item, but I'm not sure. There's Greed. Good that he's here and not in the shop. So we should be able to go to the shop and actually buy stuff. And we do have a lot of money, 29 cents. It's pretty good. Should allow us to get 2 items as long as we get 1 more penny. If we can buy 2 Steam sales, that would be great, but I don't think that's gonna happen. Book of Secrets, garbage item. So let's just use it and leave. I should blow up the skulls, I think. I might have actually been able to get all of the skulls had I put the bomb in the middle. I didn't think about it. But we do, in fact, have mega bombs, and they do have a bigger reach than I expect that they do. So I need to kind of remember that. There's Book of Revelations. We should be able to get a decent amount of HP between here and Mega Satan if we're lucky. Just get in close. Hopefully get the flies to aggro on the skulls. I will spend a bomb to blow open 2 of those skulls, and we picked up the world. I'm just gonna use it now. Credit card, which allows us to get free items from the shop. It's important to realize that this does not allow us to get items and then restock the shop. If we use the credit card in the shop, That's it. Restock will not work. So if there's good items in the shop and I want them, I can use credit card. Otherwise, I should probably save credit card and use it on a deal with the devil that I like, because then I can get the deal with the devil items for free. And at this point, I think that's probably what I'm going to do. We do in fact have the curse of blindness. So we do not know what we are going to get from our shop. I don't want to use credit card and then just get two really crappy items. Then again, we could get two really good items, but you never know. That's kind of the risk you run. So I think what we're going to do is kill this guy and kill this guy. We're definitely going to go into the golden chest here. I hit myself with the dang bomb because I'm not fast enough. Maggie speed, man. When you're not used to it, it's a real pain to deal with. I could also just buy a bunch of HP, but I want to run the risk of buying some items here. Okay, homing bombs, that's pretty good. I definitely approve of that. And Book of Shadows, with all of these close range familiars that we have, could be extremely powerful. And in fact, I might want to just use Book of Revelations as much as I can on this floor, buy the spirit hearts, buy the batteries. I guess I don't need to buy the batteries, I can just buy the spirit hearts and they will replenish. And then just take Book of Shadows with me, because I can use that once every three rooms. And with all of these familiars that I have, we can do a number on the enemies. Ooh, I almost got hit by that little spider there. It's a bit annoying with these fires, and I did in fact get hit by one there. Let's take out the fires. There we go. Then we can take out the spiders. Kind of hard to see them when they turn into stone, thanks to Mom's contact. But we managed to make it work. All right, now let's take out these fires and use our mega bombs to blow open all of these delicious skulls, see what we can get out of them. Okay, got a lot of cards. If there's a good card, I still want to use the credit card on a deal with the devil if I can. So even if it's a really good card, I might just end up leaving it. That was dumb of me. That was really dumb of me. I wanted to get in front of him. Or I should say I wanted to get around him, but that's obviously not how that ended up working. I am gonna take the money instead of giving it to Bump Friend. If I can get some extra stuff from the shop, I do want to get it. Some extra spirit hearts would be fantastic. Could also just buy another item if I get, ooh, what's this? Ivy bag, portable blood bank. Eh, it could be better. Joker. Well, there is, ooh, two Jokers. Two Jokers means we use one right now.
Joker.
We take Odd Mushroom, that's good. We take the Mark, that's great. Oh, the damage upgrades. Nice. Having some extra damage upgrades is lovely. And it also means that it doesn't matter if we get a deal with the devil, because we've already seen what's in there. There's nothing. We're not gonna use a credit card on this floor, but I can still save it and use it on another floor in the future. So that's what I'm going to do. Don't need to backtrack quite yet. Kind of got a little bit confused about what direction I was heading thanks to that skull room and the trip to the deal with the devil. But I want to save that for the... I want to save the backtracking for when we're done with this floor, which we are after this room. Go do one more room, get a charge on Book of Revelations, get some more HP, I've already bought the Book of Shadows, but take the Book of Shadows with me. Maybe buy one more item and see what's in the shop. These flies are doing a lot of damage. Thanks to those damage upgrades, they are gonna just do that much better for us. And I forget, now that we had the chub aggroed with the rotten baby here. Yeah, excuse me, another sneeze there. Now that rotten baby has aggroed flies on chub, we can just kind of leave chub and focus on something else, fire on the other side of the room, and the flies will home in on him from anywhere. All right, one more room of combat. Golden chest, I will open it. Who knows what we can get out of it. Again, I'm hoping for some good items from these chests, but so far we have not gotten any good payouts. It'll happen though, it'll happen. There's a Book of Revelations. There is just an HP up. You know what? I cannot complain about just getting an HP upgrade. It does mean that we probably will not be able to get rid of all of our HP. You know, I'm going to be hopefully using a credit card to steal items from a deal with the devil. Maybe I don't want to do that, though. Maybe I do want to actually lose this. Maybe I actually do want to lose this HP and then get permanent forward invincibility or something. That's just a straight up HP upgrade. And another spirit heart. Now we're actually at max HP. Don't even need to buy a HP or battery from the shop. So we can buy whatever that last item is. And then we can take Book of Shadows, go fight the boss, use Book of Shadows. Should be a tremendously easy fight. Let's buy this one. Book of Belial. More books. All right, well, we're gonna take Book of Shadows. Book of Belial's pretty good, but three rooms, invincibility that lasts for like 20 seconds. That's really good. That's really good. With Ball of Bandage, with the Attack Fly, that's some serious damage output right there. And Mom is already almost fully dead. Mom is dead. We get the Polaroid. We've already been to the deal with the devil. Let's get out of here. Go down to the womb one, full HP. We still have the credit card. I do want to do that room. I do think that it would be worth it. Those red chests could give us a teleport to the deal with the devil. But what I do want to do is I do want to want to blow up on those guys and get some extra money for Bumfriend, but I do want to get a Book of Shadows charge so that I can, in fact, I might as well take it, so that I can, in fact, use it on this room. And if I use it on this room, then I should be able to really easily fight that room without taking any damage, because we should be able to chew through the bosses in no time flat, as you saw with the Mom's Heart fight. Well, Mom's Foot fight. Little risky getting in close, and I did manage to get hit there. Oops. Hopefully we get some HP out of these chests over here, though. Open the red chests last, because if they teleport you, you want them to teleport before you use the item so that you don't lose the charge on it. Fistula should be pretty easy. Book of Shadows wore off? Wow, that was not as long as I was expecting Book of Shadows to last. I expected it to last a lot longer than that. I guess I might be thinking of the Alga's rune being so long lasting in terms of its invincibility, because Book of Shadows, not as long as I was expecting, but still pretty good. And the only reason why it didn't fully last for this room is because there's three bosses, not one. That's all right. Oh yes, Goat Hoof, thank you, speed upgrade, awesome. That is going to help out tremendously. Speed has been my biggest problem so far in this entire run. I haven't gotten one speed upgrade. Finally got some damage upgrades. Damage is still a little bit low though. I would like it to be higher. I would like the fire rate actually probably to be higher right now. I think that's the biggest problem, is we shoot very slowly. Ah, couldn't run away from the freaking earthquake attack. I really do hate that attack. There's not a lot you can do to
Judgment.
Get out of the way of it. We'll play Judgment with this 9 cents. We're not doing anything with it, so we might as well see what he pays out with. Red Heart doesn't help me. If that was a Spirit Heart, though, that would be pretty good. An HP upgrade is good. I am glad that I took the time to play him. I also forgot, again, that on the womb, these guys are four-way shots. I really don't like it, but you know, what you gonna do? Is that a tinted rock? No. There's a secret room over here though, so we will visit that first. Oh, I hate these guys. They're so fast, and they hit me. HP not doing so well. I am not playing very well. Hopefully we can make this run work. I'd like it, you know, I'd like it if we could get this run to work. Kill Mega Satan, not have to worry about him again. actually make progress on stuff. Play has left a lot to be desired, though, with these relatively poor dodges. I did have Book of Shadows, so I probably should have just used it. I don't know why I didn't, really. BBF, I will take it. It is a explosion, and I do think it synergizes with the bombs that we have, so it's going to be a big explosion. It's going to be a poison explosion, and if I had taken butt bombs, it would also be a poop explosion. So I now kind of wish that I did, in fact, take butt bombs when I had the opportunity, but that is okay. Take care of these flies. Don't need to worry about the last one. All right. No need to use Book of Revelations. I need to remind myself that I have it and that I can, in fact, use it on rooms. Don't need to use it here. Some dinglets are not going to hit me. Should be able to dodge out of the way of these guys, no problem. All right. I will probably use Book of Shadows right here. Gertie Jr. is a pain to dodge, and if I can go into the curse room, I will do it. It wasn't worth it, but we did manage to get in and out, only taking up about, or only losing one HP, and I think that that was worth it enough to at least risk it. Hopefully that one HP doesn't come back to be, you know, the HP that I needed in order to defeat Mega Satan. Hopefully not. And we've been everywhere on this floor yet. Still haven't found the boss. Where is everybody? Almost dodged into that one. I was expecting his six-shot attack to be a little bit more normalized, or a little bit more snapped to angles. It was at a very, very odd angle that came out, and I wasn't expecting it. I am gonna pop Book of Revelations here. These guys are really annoying to hit sometimes. Hopefully we can get another charge before the boss fight. Looks like we can, as long as there's combat in the next room. There we go. I was hoping that BBF would get in there and get a kill. Did manage to take out the champion, which is the most important thing, because he is a pain to hit. I can use my range to hit these other guys, though. I should probably go back and get that bomb, so I think I will do that. No reason not to. These bombs could be very helpful for us. In fact, I'll just use one and leave. Could have gotten an HP upgrade from that. Could have gotten Placenta, which is a pretty good HP upgrade. Double Loki. Get in there. Use Ball of Bandages. Use the Attack Fly. Easy fight. We picked up Gimpy. Gimpy is really good. Should allow us to pick up some extra spirit hearts over time. Ah, and it's so much brighter now. We are out of that floor. BBF doing its thing again. Awesome. Blowing up some of these pustules so that maybe we can pick up a HP upgrade from that. That's the ideal case. That's the best case. This room is annoying as heck. The flies, though, I think is going to be good for me. I'm just gonna wait for BBF. He's gonna hit him. Oh, yes! It worked! He tried to get away, but BBF managed to knock him out. The moon, if I use the moon, I'm just gonna get lost. Fuck it, let's get lost.
The moon.
Some money is actually pretty good. Maybe give it to Bum Friend, see if he can pay out with something. And 4 more cents, he better pay out with something. Pay out with a chest, come on. HP I can't use, a card, a feather, Wheel of Fortune. Well, that probably wasn't worthwhile, but it was worth a risk, I think. Wheel of Fortune doesn't really give me anything. If I'm going to blow something up, I guess I'll put the Wheel of Fortune down so I can blow up two things at once. But I'm not going to be able to find any secret rooms because, well, I might be able to find the second secret room because it's usually close to where the boss is. Let's just use Book of Shadows. This room is annoying. And then I can just run into these guys and not have to worry about them so much. Whoops, I did not mean to pick up the nickel. I meant to give it to Bum Friend, but I wasn't really paying too much attention to when it came out. Oh, he charged me, and while he charged me, he hit his own poop, which caused him to hit me. That's kind of annoying, but there wasn't really much I could have done to avoid that. I was trying to dodge him, but he just managed to get in the way. Ooh. Now this is an interesting situation. Burnt Penny is really good. Burnt Penny would allow me to pick up a lot more bombs over time, but the problem with it is that I would have to drop the Goat Hoof, and the Goat Hoof is giving me a little bit of a speed upgrade. Let's just confirm that it is giving me a speed upgrade. Yeah, I do feel slightly slower. Actually, I feel about the same speed. I do feel slightly slower. I don't know if maybe that's just the placebo effect or if that is in fact me being slower, but why risk it? Let's just go ahead and keep the Goat Hoof. All right, boom, that is 5 more bombs for me. I could take the remote detonator, but I don't want to. I do want to stick with the Book of Shadows. I do think that the Book of Shadows is going to be key to my victory here. That's assuming that I am victorious, of course, but I do think that it is going to be a good item that's only going to get better as time goes on. As these enemies get stronger, as the bosses get more health, I'm going to need to be able to kill them. And this is kind of the only way in which I can do that right now. Our shots are not all that powerful, and got hit by the laser. No tinted rocks that I can see, that's fine. I think I'm gonna pop Book of Shadows for this room. I've got some batteries laying around, so I can go pick them up if I need to, but I do wanna take out some of these dingles. All right, we've at least cornered them in one half of the map. Well, I guess not cornered would be the word to use there, because corner implies that there's 4, or at least 3. Ho ho ho. All right, chest. 2 bombs, that is a boss room, or a boss gauntlet room right there. We can't access it because we have full health. Or to be more precise, we can't access it because we don't have 1 health. More laser rooms. Need to practice my laser dodges. I got hit by lasers on the last room, but not here. In a room with 5 of these guys, annoying as hell. My speed is still extremely, extremely low, even with the Goat Hoof, assuming that it is working. Can't get close to these guys to use the ball of bandages or the attack fly. I just kind of have to hope that I can kill them. Didn't even have a Book of Shadows charge, and I probably wouldn't have even used a Book of Shadows charge. 2 spirit hearts, that's going to be very important. I feel a lot better about the HP right now. Just let the bomb explode. Don't even risk getting close to it. 53 bombs. We have a lot of bombs. Hopefully we can use those on the cathedral, on the chest. I did not expect that bomb to explode in my face. I don't even know how that happened, really. I guess maybe a dinglet spawned and got close to me, or maybe I was just closer than I had realized. Degas, I will pop it, and now we have a map. Awesome. Second secret room is over here. So what I was saying earlier about us not being able to find the secret room, totally not actually the case, because we found it thanks to Degas. Ooh, and we picked up a ton of keys and Mom's Perfume, which gives us Charm Tears. Oh no, it's not Charm Tears, it's a Fear Shot. All right, Mom's Eyeshadow is Charmed Tears. So we should be able to push enemies away from us ever so slightly. I don't need to kill the redheads, they will die when the room ends, but it's definitely can help to kill them sooner rather than later so that they don't explode in your face. Now it's gonna get in there with the ball of bandages. I actually probably should have saved it. Now that I think about it, I should have saved the charge for when Mom's Heart got into this phase. That would have been a smart move. These bombs, I forget that they are homing, so I can just drop them, shoot them in, and they will take care of Mom's Heart, no problem. Did get a deal with the devil. Let's see what we have at offer here. Fate's Reward, Anarchist Cookbook, and Blank Card. Fate's Reward is the only thing worth taking, and credit card is worthless after this floor, so let's pop the credit card.
Credit card.
I'll take Fate's Reward. I'll take both of these items. We'll remove them from the rotation, but we are going to take Book of Shadows with us. The invincibility is more important. And now we can leave. Go up to the cathedral. Go fight Mega Satan after we visit the chest and get some extra items. This is a long run so far, but, you know, on these Mega Satan runs in particular, you only have to do them once. So, you know, there was a good, like, 5 or 10 minutes. Oh, sad bombs! The bomb synergies on this run is what's going to save me. Thank you, Chaos. But yeah, we only have to do this stuff once. And once we do this stuff once, we can hopefully have quicker runs in the future by not having to do all of this Mega Satan stuff. Sacrifice ourselves, go slow, worry about our HP. Sad bombs are awesome. Fate's Reward, pretty good pickup. Gives us a little bit higher DPS. It fires one tier for about every 10 of our tiers, which may not seem like all that much, but over time it does end up really helping, especially when you start fighting those tankier bosses. I'm just gonna pop Book of Shadows here and let these guys run into me. Our damage output is low enough that I did kind of expect myself to take damage there had I kind of stayed. I'm gonna throw in a bomb here. It homes in on him, and the sad bomb shot managed to take it out. The greed, that is. Bum friend, what do you got for me? Card, HP, bomb. The card is strength, which is actually fantastic. Should be able to do significantly more damage when we actually get down to the next floor and fight Mega Satan. Just HP on that room, nothing else. Might as well pop Book of Shadows right now, because this is the time when we want to get in there and do as much damage as possible. I will throw down a bomb as well. There we go. Fetus is dead. Isaac is doing his beam attacks. Throwing a bomb in there. One more bomb should do it. There we go. Excellent. And now we have full health, strength, Book of Shadows, which we can charge in two rooms, enough keys to open all these items on the chest, Curse of the Maze. Ooh. Okay, we're gonna take Bumbo. It would be cool if we can get Bumbo leveled up. I'll take Bob's Brain before we go in to the Satan fight, but I'm not going to take it right now because I do think it'll just get in the way. That was definitely a good homing bomb shot. That was a pretty good homing bomb shot too, but I actually didn't want Chubb to eat the bomb. Didn't manage to kill him actually. Still alive. A lot of HP dropping. I'm not sure why a lot of times on the chest HP just drops very frequently. Halo, excellent. I think at this point we're not going to take Dead Cat either. It's an interesting pickup. We do have Guppy's Tail, but we don't have any other Guppy items. So another Guppy item would have to spawn for me to want to take Dead Cat. Just drop a bomb, drop another bomb, let them do their work. These sad bomb shots will hit stuff even if the bomb explosion does not. And this is a standard chest room right here, just a bunch of monstros. And the fact that we are not quite able to kill them very quickly is an indication that our damage by ourselves is terrible. But because we have some pretty good synergies going on here, I think we will be fine on the Mega Satan fight. And I haven't actually mentioned this, but we did pick up the Trinity Shield, which is fantastic when you're fighting Mega Satan. Mega Satan has a lot of bullet hell attacks, especially in his last phase. And we can basically just ignore that entire attack sequence. We can just stand still, let the Trinity Shield just block all of his shots, and that's great. That's fantastic. We will just be able to hopefully not take any damage at that phase. We'll try to throw in a couple bombs in here, I think. But now that I think about it, these what are these guys? Blastocysts. These blastocysts are not actually approaching me, so I don't really need to worry about them too much. I can just stand back, shoot a bunch of shots, and kill them eventually. Alright. Oh, and you know what? I haven't even mentioned it, that the chess music is so loud, because I completely forgot that, like, a month ago, I edited my game's sound files so that they would be a lot quieter, and it's so much more moody on the chest now that the music isn't just blaring in your ears. I can hear so much better, I imagine you can too. Oh, it's fantastic. Super greed. I don't need to dodge his shots at all, I can just kind of stand still. And we get a quarter, which is good, but it doesn't do anything for us. I'm gonna take it, I guess. Maybe I'll get money equals power or something. And at this point, I'm just kind of doing the rest of this floor just to see what we get. You know, we picked up the Halo and Trinity Shield. Those two items alone make this venture out into the chest worthwhile. Tremendously so. There wasn't really anything I could do about that. It kind of spawned with the BFF. The spider jumped at it and flew up. It happens. I guess what I could have done is just use Book of Shadows. I didn't really think about it. And I got hit there again from BFF. I gotta stop taking this BFF damage because I need this HP for the Satan fight. It's not gonna be a quick fight. It's gonna take some time. That was the worst homing I've ever seen on a bomb. Instead of being still and hitting three Lokis, it chased one bomb fly out of the way and then just blew up basically nothing. Toss a bomb in there, take care of Ragman. I guess I should just use maybe not one bomb a room, but one bomb a room when it's an annoying boss that I don't want to fight or that I think I might get hit on, because these bombs, they pack a punch right now. Okay, there's a secret room up here. Let's visit it. Left hand? Oh, right. Curse of the Maze, I do believe. Yeah, there it is. There's another chest. That means more items for us. Maybe some money. Oh, what am I thinking? I literally just said that it was going to be more items for us. But Curse of the Tower is amazing right now. And it might sound strange to say that. Curse of the Tower is actually a terrible item. But because we have all of these bomb synergies, they're going to apply to Curse of the Tower, which means when we get hit, we drop, you know... Oh, no. Now I have to make the decision. when we get hit, we're going to drop a lot of bombs. They're going to explode randomly. It's going to be great. It's going to be great to see. And now I do have to make the decision. Do we take Dead Cat 9 lives and get... and lose 6 HP and get Guppy, or do we not do that? I don't know. Oh, there's freaking Skype again. Mute! Stay muted. Oh, nah. Now the window's in my way, gotta get rid of it. There we go. It's an interesting situation. It's an interesting conundrum. Minus 6 HP, plus Guppy, or just fight the boss right now. Well, not right now, but when we're done with this section of the room, or the floor. Honestly, I don't know. I should not have stood there. But there is the Curse of the Tower in action. At this point, I think we can't, because our HP is just running. It's running down. It's running low. I keep getting hit by the BFF shots, annoyingly enough. BFF is a good item, but it's also kind of being a pain in my ass right now. Haven't gotten any Gimpy shot, or what is it, Gimpy the Gimp? Any Gimp payouts yet. There is one Spirit Heart over here. I'm not going to take it just so that it's there. Just kind of drop these bombs off and let them do their thing. Got a lot of bombs. We're not gonna use all of them on Mega Satan at this point. The Empress plus Pandora's Box unfortunately just gives us one penny. Book of Shadows, Strength, Empress. Strength is better. It gives you one HP when you use it, so I'd much rather have that. And we get one more Spirit Heart. I will leave it. just in case. We'll throw a bomb in there. Hopefully BFF can get the shot in. No, it can't, but that's fine. With Ragman in the line, not really moving, some good payouts there. We could use portable slot and maybe get some payouts out of that. I'm using some bombs where I think or know that the monster is going to be landing in. Freeze him, hit him with some shots. There we go. Haven't really been using the fly or the ball of bandages lately, which I think is a good sign. It means that we don't need to use it. I haven't been feeling the need to use it in order to actually get stuff done. Now I should be able, for the most part, to just kind of stand still when these shots come in. Trinity Shield should keep me protected. Throw some bombs in there. Kill Blue Baby. I don't really know why I'm doing this fight. I don't need to in order for any accomplishments. I guess just for completionist's sake for this floor. Let's just make sure we do this fight. And there he goes. Didn't take any damage, which is good. Don't go out the chest. We are not done with this floor yet. How quickly can I do this? It's not terribly quickly, but it's not terribly fast either. Luck up. Oh, thank you for getting that right now. The least opportune moment. If I can get some spirit hearts, I'd be happy with it. But I think we'll be fine fighting Mega Satan. We've got some relatively decent HP, relatively decent damage. I should have maybe let Bumbo or Bumfriend pick up that penny. Range down doesn't really hurt me all that much, so I don't really mind it. Rainbow Worm doesn't really do much for me. Down to 5 cents. I'm not gonna pick up the money, I'm just gonna let these guys deal with it. Bumbo can't get any of the money, unfortunately. I would like to get Bumbo leveled up, but that's not gonna happen, obviously. All right, Spirit Heart. Spirit Heart, Empress. No, we're gonna take the Strength card with us. We are not going to use the Dead Cat item, we're just gonna leave that. I'd much rather have 6 HP than be Guppy, I think, at this point. Yeah. Yeah. We're gonna have max HP when we use the strength, so I think that's fine.
Strength.
Stay still? No, thank you. I'm gonna be dodging my ass off. These sad bombs, I think these sad bombs are really what's going to be the thing that wins it for me, because they are doing a number. One of them almost took out the first Mega Satan form just right then and there. Although I think that was in fact Bob's brain that did it. All right, he's gone. Throw a couple of those sad bombs down. I was trying to time it so that the bomb would go off when the wave ended, but there was still one more segment of the mini boss alive, Envy. Kind of toss a bomb in there, maybe get it to home in on him. All right, I do have Bob's brain. Bob's brain, the range on that, the explosion radius is so big. I guess that's because we do have a mega bomb. The explosion radius on these bombs is incredible. I can't avoid getting hit by them, but we are going to win this, I think. Oop. There was a bomb over there, and I don't know why it didn't just go off, but it's fine. Book of Shadows, we're gonna pop it. We're gonna use all of our bombs, we're just gonna stay still right here, and this fight is over. Mega Satan done with Maggie. Excellent. I guess it's not quite done yet. There it goes. Don't get hit by the bomb. All right, achievement unlocked. Red Baby has appeared in the basement. Well, that's Maggie done with Mega Satan. We weren't able to do Hush. Again, it's kind of annoying, but we only have to do all of that sacrifice stuff once. Mega Satan is done now. I don't need to do that 10-minute long sacrifice stuff. I don't need to worry about HP. I don't need to take Yumheart and think, okay, I can use this to help myself sacrifice later. I can kind of be a little bit more aggressive, a little bit less defensive, and a little bit less futurely minded, I guess. But anyways, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again for the next run.